great sign appeared in heaven, a woman clothed with the sun, and the moon beneath her feet, and on her head a crown of 12 stars. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. The Lord be with you. My dear friends, welcome to Mass today on this glorious feast of the Assumption of Our Blessed Lady. A particular welcome to those of you who are sharing at home in this celebration during live streaming. It is a joy for me to be with you to celebrate today. I look back over the 21 years that I was parish priest here as among the happiest of my priestly ministry, with so many wonderful memories of people and the various occasions and celebrations that we have. And this has always been a very close, warm community, and long may that continue. So, as we rejoice in our faith today, and we offer this Mass this morning for the repose of the soul of Philip Nash, let us also recognize in the presence of the Lord our need of him, of his forgiveness, and above all the grace to persevere. The Lord does not expect of us that we necessarily overcome our failings and sinfulness, but that we remain faithful to him. Lord, blessed are those who have not seen you and yet believe. Lord, have mercy. Lord, if anyone listens to your word and keeps it, they are your mother or brother or sister. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are Son of the living God and Son of Mary, a man like us in all things but sin. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You are in the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who assumed the Immaculate Virgin Mary, the mother of your Son, body and soul into heavenly glory, grant, we pray, that always attentive to the things that are above, we may merit to be sharers of her glory, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, for ever and ever. Amen.
The sanctuary of God in heaven opened, and the Ark of Covenant could be seen inside it. Now a great sign appeared in heaven, 12 stars on her head for a crown. She was pregnant and in labor, crying aloud in the pangs of childbirth. Then a second sign appeared in the sky, a huge red dragon which had 7 heads and 10 horns, and each of the 7 heads crowned with a coronet. Each tail dragged a third of the stars from the sky and dropped them to the earth. And the dragon stopped in front of the woman as she was having the child, so that he could eat it as soon as it was born from his mother. The woman brought a male child into the world, the son who was to rule all the nations with an iron scepter. And the child was taken straight up to God and to his throne, while the woman escaped into the desert, where God had made a place of safety ready. Then I heard a voice shout from heaven, "Victory and power and empire forever have been won by our God, and all authority for his Christ." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. On your right stands the queen in garments of gold.
On your right stands the queen in garments of gold.
The daughters of kings are among your loved ones. On your right stands the queen in gold of Ophir. Listen, O daughter, give ear to my words. Forget your own people and your father's house.
On your right stands the queen in garments of gold.
So will the king desire your beauty. He is your Lord. Pay homage to him. They are escorted amid gladness and joy. They pass within the palace of the king.
On your right stands the queen in garments of gold.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Death came through one man, and in the same way, the resurrection of the dead has come through one man. Just as all men die in Adam, so all men will be brought to life in Christ. But all of them in their proper order. Christ as the first fruits, and then, after the coming of Christ, those who belong to him. After that will come the end, when he hands over the kingdom to God the Father, having done away with every sovereignty, authority, and power. For he must be king until he hath put all his enemies under his feet. And the last of the enemies to be destroyed is death. For everything is to be put under his feet. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Mary has been taken up into heaven. All the choirs of angels are rejoicing.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Mary set out and went as quickly as she could to a town in the hill country of Judah. She went into Zechariah's house and greeted Elizabeth. Now, as soon as Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leapt in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. She gave a loud cry and said, "Of all women, you are the most blessed, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. Why should I be honored with a visit from the mother of my Lord? For the moment your greeting reached my ears, the child in my womb leapt for joy. Yes, blessed is she who believed that the promise made her by the Lord would be fulfilled. And Mary said, My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord, and my spirit exults in God my Saviour, because he has looked upon his lowly handmaid. Yes, from this day forward, all generations will call me blessed, for the Almighty has done great things for me. Holy is his name, and his mercy reaches from age to age for those who fear him. He has shown the power of his arm. He has routed the proud of heart. He has pulled down princes from their thrones and exalted the lowly. The hungry he has filled with good things, the rich sent empty away. He has come to the help of Israel, his servant, mindful of his mercy, according to the promise he made to our ancestors, of his mercy to Abraham and to his descendants forever. Mary stayed with Elizabeth about 3 months and then went back home. The Gospel of the Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Looking around the church and also behind the masks, I recognize so many familiar faces. I like to think that we haven't aged, we've just matured like fine wine. I think that's the best way of looking at things. It's the most positive way. Thinking about this glorious feast day today, the voice of God isn't just made manifest through the hierarchy, but through the people of God as well. And from the second century, it was the belief among those early Christians that the Mother of God was not allowed to see corruption, and that she was taken body and soul into heaven. And that faith that those early Christians had was affirmed in 1950 when Pope Pius XII proclaimed as a solemn dogma of faith the Assumption of the Virgin Mary into heaven. But on a purely human level, you and I will recognize the intimate bond between a mother and her son. And our Blessed Lady, through the whole of the Lord's life, was there at his side, not only physically, but spiritually. And she experienced and must have been touched by the joys, but above all, by the sorrows that he faced, and ultimately his death on the cross. But one can also imagine that our Blessed Lord, out of love for his mother, wanted to preserve her from decay, and did what he would do in any situation because of the bond between them. He took her home to himself in the kingdom of God. But the wonderful thing for us today is to know that a human being like us, albeit without sin, has entered into the realms of heaven. And that, my dear friends, is our goal, it is our destiny, it is part of the precious gift of our faith, knowing the meaning and purpose of life itself, that we are on that pilgrimage towards complete union with God, and it is her prayers as our Heavenly Mother that we ask for today as we honor her and whenever we think of her with love in our hearts. When our Lord was moments away from his death, he spoke those wonderful words to St. John, My son, this is your mother, and to his mother, this is your son. And the church has always held in those words the gift of our Blessed Lady as the mother of all of us, someone who loves us as her children, and whom we can always turn to in the joys and sorrows of life. So may I wish you all a very, very happy feast day and enjoy the rest of this day as a gift from God Himself. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And with one voice and one heart, proclaim together our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Lord Jesus, in obedience to the will of your Father, you became a man like us in all things but sin, and you found in the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary the heaven that you had left. May our prayers be granted according to your will and through her loving intercession.
Lord God, following in her words proclaimed in the Magnificat, may Mary's recognition of her holiness and exuberance to submit to you will be reflected in our own faithfulness. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Almighty God, your supreme pontiff, Francis, our Pope, the bridge between you and your Church, is now frail in body, so we pray for his strength to continue his ministry. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Ever-living God, your servant Moses cried to you in anguish on behalf of his people, Israel, facing hardship in the wilderness, and you listened to him. Our anguished prayers are offered to you to help us alleviate the distress of so many in our world today. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord God, may politicians with aspirations to lead our country show humility and concern for others, as exemplified by our Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Merciful Father in heaven, bless our holidays at this time, however taken, so that we return to both church and work refreshed in mind and body to serve you with vigor. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Bless and strengthen all who are sick and those who care for them, especially those known to us and those whose names are listed on the parish newsletter. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those who have died recently, especially Monica de Jong, Tom Parsons, Mary Quintal, Alice Shinners, Philip Nash, Laurie Jemson, Mick and Linda Withy, and Betty Madonna. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We bring before you those whose anniversaries occur at this time, especially Tom Coyne, Albert Ferrez, and Moira Gallagher. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray especially this day to our Blessed Lady as we say,
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
We now take a moment in silence to pray for our own intentions.
Heavenly Father, help us all to be attentive to your will and to put it into practice, as did the Blessed Virgin Mary, that we may know the gift of your Son's peace that this world can never give. And we make this and all our prayers through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, Vita Dulcedo, et Spes Nostra Salve. A te clamamus, exsules filii Eve, a te suspiramus, Gentes et flentes in hac lacrimarum vale. Ea ego, advocata nostra, illos tuus, misericordes oculus, ad nos converte. Et Iesum, benedictum proctum ventris tui, nobis post hoc exilium ostende. O clemens, O Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May this oblation, our tribute of homage, rise up to you, O Lord, and through the intercession of the most blessed Virgin Mary, whom you assumed into heaven, may our hearts aflame with the fire of love, constantly long for you. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. I'm going to offer this morning, or we are going to offer this morning with you, the first Eucharistic prayer. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For today the Virgin Mother of God was assumed into heaven as the beginning and image of your Church's coming to perfection, and a sign of sure hope and comfort for your pilgrim people. Rightly, you would not allow her to see the corruption of the tomb, since from her own body she marvelously brought forth your incarnate Son, the author of all life. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you and with joy proclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and Vincent Gerard, our Bishop, and all those holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and apostolic faith.
through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Let it become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we your servants and your holy people offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as ones who were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant, Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest, Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angels to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation of the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember, Lord, also your servants who have gone before us in the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, to those sinners, hoping your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints, and Yet thus we beseech you into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen. And let us offer one another some sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. All generations will call me blessed, for he who is mighty has done great things for me. Thank you, Lord. Body of Christ. Thank you. The act of spiritual communion with all those who are watching the celebration and sharing in it in their own homes through live streaming. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Having received the sacrament of salvation, we ask you to grant, O Lord, that through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, whom you assumed into heaven, we may be brought to the glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord. Amen. I hope you all enjoy the gift of this day and the coming week. Just to say, in case you're wondering who this very distinguished priest is here, Canon Brian O'Shea, my friend for 53 years, who often came to the parish here when I was parish priest, and I know Brian too has very fond memories. Look after yourselves and take care. And again, it's been wonderful to be with you to celebrate Mass today. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go and proclaim the good news.